If you place a crossover in a three-way, 200 hertz or 400 hertz or whatever, it's right where voices have all their character. And you get a speaker that has a difficulty carrying the energy all the way to the bass. This we avoid completely with a 2.5-way design. Normally you will build a speaker with a crossover. In a three-way design, a crossover between the bass and the midrange. And while you can make a three-way measure flat, there will always be this sense of lack of energy because you have a giant phase shift over the crossover region, and you have that right where voices are predominant. So it's really difficult to make, or virtually, for me at least, impossible to make a three-way speaker that carries the energy all the way to the deepest bass. This is possible with a 2.5-way because you don't have this electrical phase shift from the crossover networks blended into that. So essentially what we do is we add in a little more volume, a little more bass with the bass drivers, making it a 2.5-way rather than a 3-way speaker. The advantage of that is that we avoid the big phase shifts you have in crossovers. But the 2.5-way design puts more strain on the bass mid driver because it needs to extend all the way from the deepest bass all the way up to crossover for the treble. And that puts a harder load on it. So we need to do some modifications to the driver. That means that the mid-range, we make a little lighter in the membrane than we do with the drivers that runs the bass. And that way it doesn't have so difficult starting and stopping and doing bass transients, so we don't get any problem with too large excursion bottoming out. And we are capable of doing that because we have control over the drivers, so we can tailor our drivers for a 2.5-way. We also use some clever designs in our cabinets that prevents the drivers from getting overloaded in the deepest bass. And that way we can get the power handling that is sufficient, but maintain this continuum from the deepest bass all the way up to the treble.